Hello, hello. This is Jennifer Bagley, CEO of CI Web Group, and today we're going to be doing a website review and analysis on Allied Elements. The website address is www.allied-elements.com. On the left-hand side, we have the restoration and cleaning services company, and on the right-hand side, we have the website grader report. So we're going to walk through some of the information that shows up in the key performance indicators on the website grader report, and then go back to the site, and we'll kind of go through both. Now, I do want to start off this session with really reiterating the fact that the evaluations that I do on these, one, they're not intended to bash anyone. Sometimes I get flustered and frustrated because I see small business owners being taken advantage of, but these are not intended to belittle or be mean to anyone. Building a website is complicated. Complicated. I feel like I am a relatively smart person, but when my developers and coders start talking, I immediately feel about 2 cents tall and not very educated, because there is just so much to it. It is impossible, unless you live in this world day in and day out and you live around these geniuses, coders, developers, security experts, SEO engineers, and so forth, it is impossible for you to know all the ins and outs. Also, the evaluations that I do, I am utilizing a free website evaluation tool called Website Grader. This is an aggregation tool, which means it aggregates data from different areas and it pulls it into a simplified report for you to be able to see what's going on with your site. However, internally, within our own company, if we're going to look at the interior depths of the site, there are much more sophisticated tools that we utilize to analyze websites. Everything from heat maps and sensors to be able to monitor traffic, eyes, views, where people go, A/B variant testing to analyze pages and buttons and navigation, multivariate testing, and so forth. So the website grader and website review sessions that I do online, these are very, very high level, basic overviews. We are definitely not getting into the true fundamental elements of how to make a marketing engine on the internet, how to code a site properly, and so forth. So, and I don't need to go there, because 99% of the sites that we have come through our review request form and our free consultation, they are missing the basics, absolute basics. So it's no point in overwhelming people with a bunch of too technical data when it's not necessary. We just want to get the basics down and get the people that watch our website reviews familiar with looking at core fundamentals, key performance indicators that are very, very simple that anybody can implement into their website. And then when you get going with some of our more advanced training and education, of course, we'll get into some of those other areas for those who are ready to take it to the next level. So I just wanted to start off with that. Now let's get back to Allied Elements, the restoration and cleaning services. I love the fact that as soon as I get to the site, I can see that they are in Denton and Louisville. That is great, and you can see that right in the call to action at the top. I love the fact that you can see exactly what it is that they do, even in the header area: emergency flood service, water damage restoration, residential carpet cleaning, commercial carpet cleaning, equipment sales and rentals. And this is, I go to 100 sites that I get to the site and I have no clue what they do, and I couldn't figure it out for the life of me. So I appreciate the simplicity of letting people know this is what we do. Now, this is a little funny. Water damage and restoration services in Denton, Dallas, Plano, Fort Worth, Allied Elements. That's a really interesting place to put a page title, but we'll let that go for now. That might be trying. I don't know. We'll let that go for now. Now, as far as the overall site design, there are some things that I like. I love this header area up here. I like the need service now. We can call you within 30 minutes. We have a quick form call me now button. Great call to action. I love the there when you need us 24/7 call to action. I like our would you like to get your next carpet cleaning free? The referral program that they can join. So it's a good group of call to actions on the front page of a site. Some other things that I like. I love the navigation. It's very simple and clean. The services area, we need to make sure that the services that you have up here are the identical services that you have here. And you need to have one page per service. So technically, you should have a page for emergency flood service, water damage restoration, residential carpet cleaning, commercial carpet cleaning equipment, sales, rentals, and then you can go into these other ones as well. But it's very important that these match these. So I'm going to go ahead and click on one of those. I want to see how this permalink structure goes. So what we've done is we've created this kind of center. It looks almost like a category management. We have allied elements services. This is not necessary. So the services page that is the parent page to all of these, we should not have expanded this out like this because allied elements is the domain name. So repeating it is just taking away very valuable permalink space. It should just go into residential carpet cleaning Denton Dallas. And let's see here, carpet cleaning Denton Dallas. So this is an extremely good permalink. But we kind of killed it by putting this too long of a page title over here. So that needs to be fixed. Let me go ahead and skip into their blog. And we'll notice some of the things I noticed on the blog just standouts right away is the only type of categorization that we're utilizing is date. That's not great because categories and tags for blogs are really, really important and can help you gain search engine positioning for specific phrases. So technically each one of these services should have a blog category and we should be able to search by category. So if I want to look in the cleaning category, I should be able to. If I want to look in the emergency flood category and see all the posts related to floods, then I should be able to. Commercial is obviously going to be very different than residential. So one, from a user interface standpoint, I don't want to have to push my residential and my commercial people through the same blog areas. I also want to give my users visiting the site a little bit more control over the content that they want to get out of your blog, and that can be done through blog categories. Also, recent blog posts. Also, you could have suggested posts. So let's dig in and see if this suggests. So this doesn't suggest anything similar. There is no social media integration. I can't share this. I can't push it out to my social network. I can comment. It's interesting use of tags. We'll have to come back to tags and talk about that from an SEO standpoint. We need to fix that as well. TDAR, allied elements, tornado damages, Denton. So this is decent. I see we're kind of trying to keyword shove all of the locations inside here. What you may want to do is have categories for each of the primary cities that you're located in. So if you do business in Frisco, Prosper, Little Elm, Crossroads, Darby, Aubrey, Denton, Plano, and so forth, you might want to have a category. That way this post can be attached to several different categories. So it can be attached to it can be attached to each of the locations, plus it can be attached to tornado damage repair. So that's going to make it a lot easier. By stuffing this page title in here with all these phrases, you're losing value. You only have 60 characters for this page title. So let's go up and look at how it looks in the permalink. We have way too much. So we have the blog category, which is titled water. So one thing, notice these, we have underscores here. Underscores are not allowable. You need to be using dashes, hyphens like these. So that's killing your SEO. Water restoration, carpet cleaning, blog. And then you have the date. And then you have this really long permalink. This is way too much. This has got to be fixed. You're like 1 yard to the touchdown. So you're adding content, which I love. I know she kind of started really hot and heavy and then kind of fell off the wagon, adding less content over the months. So we need to bump that back up. But you probably, problem is if you have a blog and you start off and you're really hot and heavy and you're adding content on a regular basis and then over the months and then over the months and then over the months, you notice my phone isn't ringing. Or I'm not generating traffic, or I'm not creating leads. My call to actions are not working. You have a significant problem, and you can really get discouraged and stop adding traffic or stop adding content to your site. We don't want to do that. So, a lot of times, not having the right infrastructure can discourage you from adding blog content, which is extremely important to your business. But I understand how that can get frustrating if it's not generating traffic, which based on just an initial overview, and I can kind of tell with looking at the site, there's some fundamental things wrong with it. So even though you have the right behavior and the right methodology and maybe even the right strategy, not having the right architecture is going to hurt you. All right, so let's go back over to Website Grader and continue to go through. Site grade's 59 out of 100. And blog grade, this is, we don't need to do this with our blogs. And plus, we should not be using underscore. Anybody that knows SEO knows not to use underscores. They should be using hyphens. So if you're outsourcing this, that doesn't make sense. They should know better than that. If you're doing it internally, this is just a good tip for you. And that's a common mistake for people trying to do this in-house. Blog grade's 23 out of 100, so it's not really doing as well as it could for many reasons. Like I said, a poor use of tags, poor use of category management, not as great of SEO on pages we could, but we'll leave that at that. Index pages, now we have an issue. So we've got something going on over here on the page that is preventing Google from indexing those pages. Let's go see what we have. So we need to not wrap things in containers, first of all. We have way too much online styling. All of this is hard-coded styling. It's called inline styling. Style sheets should be over on the right-hand side here. You'll notice there's very few style sheets, which means this doesn't have a really good CSS cascading style sheet. Let's go to home and see what we've got going on here. So we've kind of attempted to put together a very simple cascading style sheet. Metadata, water damage and restoration service down. Way too much. This is called keyword stuffing. This is a no-go. You cannot put in every city you do business with inside your header title and your header description and your key phrases. You've got to be able to use blog categories and page titles and post titles to be able to identify these different areas. You cannot shove them in here like this. You're only allowed 60 key phrases or 60 characters in your page title, homepage page title, and 160 in your description, and about 10 key phrases for the per page. So those are not good. But I still can't figure out why Google is not indexing your content. I am guessing it's because this is wrapped inside of a container. The whole site is inside this container. But I would need one of our coders to be able to look further. All right, so let's come back here. Water damage and restoration services, indent and place, so forth. You can get rid of allied elements. This is a little bit long, and again, we're really stuffing the key phrases inside your descriptions when we need to be focused on services that you do. Better SEO on page per page will help you, definitely. Another kind of rookie move, whoever set up the URL and the site did not get the 301 redirect set in, so you're not getting full credit from an SEO standpoint for the site. It thinks these are two different sites. After 3 years, 9 months, and 3 weeks, that's a really low page rank. So to be trying to do all the right things, but to have that page rank is kind of a bummer. Also, backlinks. At some point, you've got to start a backlinking program or be publishing content out to social media networks. Social media publishing is one of the most important things on a site. That is, when you add content to your blog, that your blog is publishing that content out to your social media networks. That is one going to help you with links. Also, you've got to start some article writing where people are writing articles about different issues, and they're posting those articles on other sites, other blogs, forums, and so forth, so that you can start increasing your backlinks to the site. Mobile optimization needs updated. Very little, if no social media integration. So directly from the homepage of the site, I can tell that there's no way I can follow them on Facebook or Twitter. There's no videos, no YouTube, no RSS feed. links. So from a transparency standpoint, if somebody is choosing between you and another company and they have the ability to see all the testimonials, interaction, and content on someone else's social site, such as Facebook or whatnot, then they're definitely going to have the upper hand on trying to get that business. There is an RSS feed, but there's nowhere to sign up for it. And that's done with Adam, and basically no traffic. So the biggest issue you've got going on here is none of your pages can be indexed. Let me see if I can get somebody to help with that. Hey, Josh, would you be able to get Chris? See if you can bring him over here. That would be great for just a second. Let me see if I can get one of our coders to come over and take a look at the site and give us some more insight on what's happening with this website. The next thing we'll do, though, while we're waiting, I'm going to see if I can get our smarty pants over here, is I'm going to open up the web design firm that created this site, and let's go ahead and get this page going on a website review. Hello, Chris.
Hello.
Hang on 1 second, and I need your help with something. We're recording a website review. I'm going to go grade this while we're waiting, though. This is the site. So it's Allied Elements, and pages are not being indexed, zero traffic, and I don't know why.
Does it have any internal links?
It does. It has like, I want to
wow.
say...
I like how they specified the keywords in plain text as well.
They did, and they did it at the top too.
Weird.
So they put it inside the header. They totally stuffed it in all the pages.
I think that's exactly what happened. They just had no idea what they're doing. They're like, maybe this is how you like keywords.
I don't know, but it says no pages can be indexed. Can you look at it?
Yeah.
Let me move my stuff here. Hang on, you guys. He needs space. Let me move.
Okay. Where's right click on this bad boy?
Oh, here, trade me. There you go.
PC mouse?
Yeah.
That's cool.
PC mouse on the Mac. That's hot, huh?
Yeah.
I bought myself a PC keyboard, too.
That's so funny. I can't believe it was compatible.
We did a lot of research this weekend.
Yeah?
Yeah. Now I have a big bad boy PC keyboard on my huge Mac screen. So what's happening? Anything you see?
I guess they do have keywords in here.
They stuffed the bejesus out of them up here. Look.
Yeah. Oh, that's just going to be ignored. Your scroll is inverted as well.
Yeah, it's backwards. I don't have it. I'm not a hardware expert in any, by any means. Notice I get hardware lectured.
I do not see in the internal. It looks like all it is a landing page. Is there internal links on that?
Well, it says so.
It
says no pages can be found at all.
I'm looking at it. New tab. They've got to be disallowing search engines somehow.
So no robots file, you think that would be?
Well, no robots file definitely isn't helpful to them, but I think one of the things they have going on is their server-side blocking Google.
What are you doing?
Looking at the server headers to see if it's responding to me differently based on the browser that I'm using. Everything looks good, actually, as far as the server headers go.
Huh. And
so
they have no traffic. None. After 3 years. Online.
You didn't just map your host file for this one?
Nope. It's a live site.
And this is their grade?
No. I just switched it. Type in, paste Allied Elements right there. Without the HTTP.
With the www?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Right there.
I didn't like that. But Does the control key work for copy? Because I was noticing the command key doesn't exist.
There's no control, and so you can only use the Windows key because I'm using a Windows keyboard on a Mac.
That's funny. Okay.
Okay, so that worked. So, 59 out of 100, didn't like that very much. Index pages, an A. I don't know why. Total keyword stuffing, been online 3 years, Google PageRank 3.9, 18 backlinks, and absolutely nothing, no traffic.
Crazy. I got a view source on this one more time because I am not seeing why. Yeah, this is just Command F. Okay, so Windows key is Command.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. So here's the deal. Oh my god. this page definitely is handwritten.
Hand coded site,
which, you know, I like to do personally. I don't recommend it for anyone else. Yeah. none of them are, all of these are relative URLs.
What does that mean?
It doesn't have the http://www.whatever. That's why all of the content management system, you know, out there on the market right now, will actually add in a full URL.
Highlight it so they can see where you're talking
about. Okay. So basically this area right here, these anchors or these hrefs aren't really crawlable by Google in a way that it can be indexed. You might as well add rel equals no follow, no index on these. So, yeah.
So they hand-coded the site.
Right.
They didn't properly...
It looks pretty. I mean, the code's easy to read.
They didn't properly hyperlink any of the pages so Google can't crawl them?
Yeah, that was a mistake.
That was
definitely
a big mistake.
Yeah, hands down. All of the CMSs right now will... Now, that's a pain for anybody that likes to move their URL because then they have to go through this nifty find and replace process across all of their databases.
So if these guys are looking to move their site, they want to get it out of this hunk of junk that unfortunately looks gorgeous but
yeah,
has some serious issues going on with it, which are causing no traffic. You can tell because they're blogging. They were blogging all hot and heavy in the beginning in 2010, and then you can see their blogging
right.
efforts slowly went down and down and down, probably because the site's not getting any traffic, not creating any leads, no conversions, and they're getting bored with it.
Yeah, 100%.
So if they were going to move it somewhere else, what do they have to do to be able to keep all these, or does it even matter because those pages haven't been indexed?
Well, it doesn't matter. They might as well start new with a CMS or some sort of solution that would better fit them. The other thing that I was thinking after looking at all this and the standardization with the indents and whatever you can... I'm sorry, I'm pointing.
Point. He's using his fingers instead of the mouse so you can see.
So basically, if you look at all of these indentation styles and everything, they may have used Front Page, like a newer version of Front Page or Dreamweaver, one that where all of these resources were local, meaning on their hard drive. So their development environment before they deployed was probably their hard drive. Then they
on
deployed.
On a computer.
Yeah, right.
Not on a server.
Right. They didn't do their development on a server or under like a staging or a sandbox.
Okay, well, before we get too far and over my head, that's enough information for me. Thank you so much because I was very stuck and I didn't know where to go.
No worries. Yeah.
Thank you.
Absolute URLs are good.
Absolute URLs are good. Okay, so see, I learn something every day. I talk about knowing enough to get me in trouble, and then I got to bring in the real smart people in order to figure this out. So, bummer. That kind of sucks. This is a great site. Big mistakes in hand coding or producing it with whether a Dreamweaver or Front Page, like Chris said. But no pages crawlable. That's bad. That's bad, bad, bad. But that's all right. That's why we're visiting. So kind of have nowhere to go but up. You've got really, really good content, so that's going to make it easier to get you flipped over into a good CMS platform with the proper infrastructure is not going to be very difficult. In fact, I think that you would be a really, really good candidate for our hybrid model. Which is option one on our CI Web Group program. So we're going to go ahead and send you over that video, which is going to explain our hybrid program. And I think that's an inexpensive way to get all this fixed, repaired, and into the proper system. Thanks so much for visiting today, and I look forward to talking with you soon. If you are interested in submitting your site for evaluation, please sign up at www.ciwebsitebuilder.com and just simply go under the Contact Us page, and you can fill out the link that says submit your website for a live review on CI Live Broadcast. Thanks again. We'll talk to you soon.